Welcome, good morning or good afternoon. It's morning for me here in sunny South Florida. It's Friday, September 15th, and I'm hanging out with Philip of PnkFrg Studios. Now, we had to reschedule this a couple of times, but better late than never because he's pretty busy over there. And we're going to talk about social gaming. We're going to talk about user-generated content. We're going to talk about how the future could be playable, and a lot of people are very bullish on this. We're going to talk about their team's incredible history with King Games. You might know them from their incredibly popular Candy Crush Saga, all right, which Philip was instrumental in scaling that. And we're going to talk about all of the awesome stuff that PnkFrg has going on. So it's a pleasure to be here hanging out with you, Philip. And how are you today?
I'm fine. First of all, thanks for the opportunity. It's a pleasure to be here on the one side, and hello to the audience. Greetings from my side. And to clarify this, thanks for the afternoon talk. I'm here in Berlin, Central Europe, so it's quite late in the afternoon. I'm looking forward to the chat.
All right, cool. Well, I don't see any beers over there just yet. So I just.
They're waiting outside. No worries. They're waiting outside.
He's in a full sober mind. Okay, so PnkFrg is a very unique, very cool gaming company that is leveraging Bitcoin for their upcoming blockbuster. Okay, so let's dive in just a little bit, real quick. Do you want to talk a little bit about yourself and about your history, just a 30,000-foot overview? And when you actually started PnkFrg Studios, because you've been working on it for a while now.
Yes, then maybe let's start with this. So just to give you a little bit of background about myself, I'm now, so first of all, I'm Philip, as you introduced me, thank you. I'm working now in the gaming industry for almost 20 years, plus minus. And in the last 20 years, I worked in different kind of gaming categories, gaming genres, how we call it. So like from online gaming, PC, social gaming, mobile gaming. I think I released in my career so up to 20 to 30 different titles. And the last 8 years before we started PnkFrg Studios, I was working for King, as you also mentioned. And I had this really great opportunity to be the first executive producer on Candy Crush Saga. So, I mean, that was for me a huge and amazing opportunity because I had this opportunity to run and to lead Candy Crush and as a game, but also as a product team from the starting point, as it has been a kind of a small social game on Facebook at the beginning, up to becoming one of the biggest, or at this time, the biggest mobile franchise with around, I would say, a 500 million monthly active users. So it was quite, it is still quite a huge thing. And PnkFrg, or let's say it like this, co-founders of PnkFrg, we worked together already at King and on Candy Crush titles, and we met together at this time. And I think out of our work together, the idea was born later as we separated as well to get together again and to found PnkFrg Studios. And PnkFrg Studios is a little bit, I would say, like when did you start? It's around 2020. It was around the beginning of the pandemics at this time, but that was the starting point of PnkFrg Studios. Yeah. Are you
All
still here,
right.
Mike? Yeah.
I am still here. Okay, so let's share a screen real quick and have a look.
Yeah.
For anyone
History.
who hasn't heard this is the game. My mom loves it. Okay, so it's got to be good to play a video game. So this was Candy Crush Saga. It
Yeah.
is still a mega blockbuster. Okay,
It
so
is, yeah.
everyone
I
know
mean,
about
that's a
that?
congratulation. Sorry to stop you, Mike, but that's like, I think I want to highlight this as well because, I mean, I'm not working on Candy Crush for a while now, but Candy Crush is alive for more than 10 years and it is still top one, or at least top three, four top grossing games in the world, at least in the Western world. And that's a big, huge respect to the Candy Crush team. What their performance they're delivering year over year is really amazing and outstanding. Just to drop this here as well. Big thank you and greetings to the Candy Crush team in case someone is listening.
Yeah, it's got to be hard to stay on the top of the charts for 10 years as a mobile game. Okay, so co-founder, managing director, PnkFrg Studios. We have the King Studio history there. So these are the beasts in gaming, as well as the other people on the team. Just moving right along here. This is their Twitter. That's PnkFrg, if you want to go ahead and give them a follow there. And this is their website, right? Which they have some early access, and they have a Discord community. And if that's something that you want access to, you can reach out and we can figure it out. So with just diving right in, because the main questions that we have here from our group is what the heck is going on? And I'm in the beta and I've been playing around with it myself. I've been answering some of the questions. Maybe we can show a little bit of what that looks like. But can we just hear in your own words kind of what the heck you're out to build with PnkFrg Studios? And by the way, we didn't touch on it, but Philip is based in Helsinki, Finland. I think most of the team over there.
Helsinki and Berlin. So our headquarter is Helsinki and most of the people are also based in Berlin. So what are we doing? It's quite easy. I think it has to do with kind of a paradigm shift. So what we have together in common as a team as well is we observed, or we have been part of the last big paradigm shift in gaming, which was from kind of classic gaming to social and mobile. And this kind of paradigm shift, what we have observed, what we have been part of also with Candy Crush, changed the gaming industry fundamentally. So it really changed everything until now. Everything what we see is now based on this kind of paradigm shift as well. And what we have observed as a team, also starting with the F-King, was kind of a similar pattern, similar trends around this kind of topic, that there is something new coming, there is something changing. And that has a lot to do with the user behavior, with a completely new generation, like call it Gen Z, for example, that is social media native, that is mobile native, that is meanwhile one of the largest generations on the planet. And this kind of pattern is similar. And we see, and the industry is observing also kind of a paradigm shift that is coming in this kind of direction by moving more towards social, by getting influenced by social. We have seen in the last years a couple of big topics around social media that is really influencing the whole entertainment industry. And what we are doing is, I would say we are doing it again. We are again jumping on a paradigm shift, what we are observing, what we are predicting in this kind of context that is happening in between gaming, mobile gaming in particular, and social media. And for that reason, what we're creating is a kind of a new experience that is placed in the intersection between mobile and mobile gaming and social media. That means it includes the best of both worlds and is tailored to the biggest generation on this planet, Gen Z, and their behavior, their demands as social media and mobile natives. And is this really integrating the opportunity for them to contribute to the entertainment angle by user-generated content? It's integrating mobile game economy mechanics really to have a really great foundation for a huge growth afterwards also from a business side. So we are really taking the best of both worlds. We're tailoring it to a new generation on their demands and their needs and creating an experience that is located in social media and gaming. You could also say what we're doing in a certain context is we are pushing even the social media format further by making it more immersive, more entertaining, more joyful, and even more interactive. So that is what we're doing a little bit to summarize in this kind of context. And what you see in the first product is kind of the first step towards this direction. And I think probably your audience and a lot of other people have tried out what we call an alpha version. So it's really the first steps what we're testing and the first versions to get really the right learnings and to go in the right direction this topic. And everything what we have tested so far is confirming this trajectory. So from a testing and validation perspective, we can already confirm all the testing, all the validations what we have done so far on quantitative level is really over exceeding our expectations. So it shows us really the trajectory and the direction what we need to have to become a really big hit, as we know it from trajectory or from trajectory around Candy Crush or King Games.
Okay, well, PnkFrg has a Vimeo page that has some pretty interesting videos on it. Some of them are a little older. I'd like to play one now if that's cool with you. Can we have a look at this thing here?
Yeah, absolutely. Now I'm getting at least forced to update all these kind of pages with the newest versions of videos and games. But definitely, let's have a look at it.
It's just a short 1 minute teaser. Let's see.
Introducing Project Alpha by PnkFrg Studios, the game where inspiration, self-expression, and laughter become playable and rewarded. Create short videos and earn Bitcoin the fun way. With a seamless wallet integration, you can cash out anytime, providing a new space for connection and creativity with different game modes. join fun, global events, and use the map to make new friends around the world. Discover and vote for your favorite videos. If the community agrees, you win Bitcoin. With more than 1 billion active users, short-form videos and user-generated content offer a massive opportunity for PnkFrg's Project Alpha to become the next social Bitcoin game success. A place to be yourself, play with friends, create videos, earn Bitcoin, and empower others to do the same. Let's make the moment playable. Project Alpha by PnkFrg Studios.
That's fun, huh?
That is totally fun. You know, as a 40-year-old man, I have no idea what the hell is going on there. But no. Okay, so we're talking about this intersection of gaming and social media. Okay, can you elaborate on that? Is there another kind of in-market product that exists or a game that it could be more comparable to? It's not quite like Pokemon Go, right? It's not like you're in real life kind of hunting these things. And it's not like a TikTok where it's just straight social. There's another sort of interactive element to it with some games and things. Can you chat a little bit about that?
Yeah. So, I mean, what you see in the last years in particular is, and you need to take the angle from both sides. You need to take the angle from the gaming side, but also from the social media side. Yeah? And you see on both sides, the industry is getting together. They are growing together by taking different elements on the street and putting it together. One side on the social media part, how social media is getting more and more gamified, in particular coming from Asia. More and more gamification elements within social media, if it's what we call the player program, if it's about a rewarding system, but also idea around bigger social platforms in the working challenges is a kind of a gamification element as well. So you see this kind of group going into the gaming world. On the other side, you also see the same elements. You see how gaming in different kind of a product can try to become more social. I mean, you have big games like Fortnite, where the conversation is almost like, are you a platform? Are you a social platform? Because we hang out together, spend time together. You have all the other mobile games who are trying to become more social, to create more, collaborate more, kind of multiplayer modes. So you have those kind of initiatives for a while now that, industries are getting together because they learn from each other and they also see the benefits from each other as well. And you see a couple of startups, a couple of innovation on the other who are going really in the segment in between to bring and to create formats that are addressing the best of both worlds. So on, and you will see it over the next time, probably other products as well. But I would say it's more a theoretical, hypothetical topic in a way, like today, like some social platforms are with games and some games are with consumers as well. So this kind of trend is already happening.
Are you lonely? Is there something missing in your life? Do you like to party? Well, listen up. It's time to spice up your life and start investing in Bitcoin companies. Lightning Ventures makes angel investing in Bitcoin startups fun and easy. Are you curious about the Bitcoin VC world? Care to join the anti-fiat Bitcoin venture capital universe? If yes, don't be shy. Fill out the application at ltng.ventures for a quick and custom onboarding. It's Bitcoin only, of course, because there is no second best. So join the motley crew of hackers, stackers, node runners, and meme masters. Whether you're a pleb or a whale, all are welcome. So groove with us. Be a part of it. Visit ltng.ventures to apply. We're gonna make it. Are you?
So let's talk timeline, right? Before we get into, and I've got a bunch of questions here from the Lightning Ventures fold. Let's just talk about timeline, okay? And we can't give out too much because this is definitely a public video on our channel, which we do from time to time. when we're investing in a company and supporting them and trying to get the word out and want to have some fun with it. So when do you expect to get out of kind of a beta and have a first initial release?
We have from a kind of a recurrent alpha version into a more kind of a beta version as well. And we are still there from a gaming world, a little bit kind of play testing in this kind of version. So what we've done and those kind of different approaches, we left a little bit this classic given approach to game development. You would not be public right now. You would be kind of a very good to test on the product. But we have decided we want the community as soon as possible, even if the product is not very stage, develop together with the community and to develop together with the feedback. That's the reason why we decided to go out in a way and develop on more or less on the market together with the community, and that is what we're doing currently. So you would probably not see something like this is how we're doing. It's a kind of an official launch. What we are doing is we are growing slowly in this kind of direction, getting bigger and bigger. And that is what's currently happening. So everyone's invited to try out the products, define it, also to provide feedback. Because that would be really the feedback directly from players to improve and to develop.
So if some of our outstanding network wanted to kick the tires, provide some feedback and hop in there, how would they go about joining?
Directly download. I think we're currently online with the latest version. I need to say, because I'm technically a little bit ahead, always. There's a version online on iOS, but also on Android. What people, it's quite simple. And feedback loop, because you have rest website before, we're currently also in the process of relaunching the website. So it will be a feedback opportunity, because we invite in particular people to provide feedback on the current state as well.
So you're playing with friends, you're creating videos, you're earning Bitcoin. Now, what do you do to earn Bitcoin? I've been playing around. I've even put a few videos up myself, and I've made these little quizzes. And what is going on here? You know, I mean, I can pick four different emojis, okay? I can take a picture. I can take a video of my cat jumping off the sofa. I can pick four different emojis or whatever question I want. I'm deciding what is the right answer. And then other people are sort of playing this. Is that right?
Yes. So what you... Yes. You have tried out this one specific game mode. So we are different game modes, what you can use. So you can combine video with a game mode. And what we always say, if I deal with both together, you're making your moment life experience playable. Because what you're doing is you're creating small games, game based on your video. And the community to provide feedback to play your game. So that is what we're doing. We've kind of different tried out this probably one of the different game modes currently online test. So the new test way what we're doing, we have different game modes to decide get the best way to it. Like, of course, how do you earn Bitcoin in this context? How do you integrate this? Is because the whole experience is based on user-generated content. We wanted to give something to creators back, realized directly. The whole idea is that you're creating content. You can participate either by the game, by getting a reward out of the game. With your content, that means you're getting a reward out of the game directly, or you're getting direct from the players, from the audience, who are your fans, who like you, who like what you're doing, etc., etc. So there's these two kind of directions, two ways how you can participate in the flow of Satoshi in this kind of context.
Okay, so question from our group is there anything else besides Bitcoin here? And why did you choose Bitcoin? I mean, it's so nice in a crypto sort of world. You know, you could have done a pink coin. You could have released some ERC-20 token or something, and you're choosing Bitcoin, which is really cool. So why Bitcoin?
There are two reasons why we have decided to go for Lightning. The one is that Lightning Network is an existing network that is supporting exactly the idea of what we have. Decentralized, direct connection between two people to transfer a value. That is what is existing here. And it's also in a way that already existing that we can use it, we can integrate it, it's working. Is because we have games like Candy Crush, we are always aiming for the biggest game. It is pretty strongly when we are using a network like the Lightning Network, we are using a biggest and brightest future in, also in scaling big and becoming big. And for that reason, I think the network and using it also as this main value flow is for me the biggest value what we have as a game on the one side, but also what we can provide to the Lightning Network on the other side. And that are the two risks. So that means on the one side, and characteristics, what we need for direct tipping, great economy, so it delivers everything we need from an organic perspective. And the second thing is like, I believe strongly the network as future, if it comes to bring food future, so big scale. And as a platform, as a game, of course, we want to have something that is growing beside us on the one side. And that is also opening in a way the door that there is not only a value that is ring fenced, like in other kind of NFTs or in other cryptos that is ring fenced to a kind of a game economy, for example. It's kind of open. And it's also a value for different areas as well. So I think those are the main points why we have chosen to go for, because we have from the first moment as we have been in contact with it, yeah, we have just been blown away. And it was like, yeah, from the first moment we have been convinced about it.
So let's talk about some of the current KPIs and traction and what you've experienced with your creators on, you know, short-term retentions and all of that, which you guys are experts of monitoring. How has it been so far as retention rates, traction, you know, average session times, all those things that you're looking at?
So we have just started the test wave, and like the old test waves, everything is clear what we said, like numbers on our side always exceed our expectations, to say it simply. Just to give you an example, like we have in the latest test, we have it means like, need to make sure that I'm uploading content, yeah, so that we really get supply and demand, user generated content, right? There's a rate of 12% of people or installs or maybe active users are uploading content. But in the current test, we have already 10%. So that must say it's really outperforming everything what we have expected on this side. And from a retention side, it's quite similar. Currently, the content creator, let me mix up a little bit the last test and this test. The content creators have currently a retention, or D1 retention of around 50%, which is already almost the target what we had for a launch. So all the numbers, the retention numbers in particular, we are tracking particular short-term engagement numbers that are going in a direction to this is what we have, and they're even exactly this kind of trajectory what we need. What we would have needed if we go for a class launch, then we would have had this kind of tasks like we had like similar like Candy Crush. So we're always using kind of benchmarks we had from kind of games like Candy Crush, which are benchmarks like blockbuster games. So that is what we are aiming for. And our trajectory is exactly in this kind of direction.
So you have a pretty vibrant community at these early stages in PnkFrg's existence, right? So your target is 100,000 for launch. Is that still correct?
That is still correct. Although I need to say that was challenging in the past because we started with this kind of without a product. Now we have already a product that means share information with the community and can push product. So we have this really good dialogue with the community. This is still the goal, yeah.
So I have a bunch of questions here, and I promised that these were going to be shorter interviews. So I don't want to get off too much in the weeds here. But first and foremost, you are a gaming company, right? This is a mobile blockbuster game that you are out to build, right? That happens to be using and leveraging Lightning and Bitcoin for monetization, rewards, incentives, and other things, right? you have to make a good game first, right? I think, I'm not sure if you were the one who told me this, but someone told me once, you know, with gaming, you can't just stick Bitcoin into a shit game and make it better. You know, you have to make the experience first. So what's cool is that the trend that we're seeing with a lot of companies and payments and fintech and other areas as well that are leveraging Bitcoin is they're not hammering and focusing on Bitcoin. So, you know, Bitcoin is not necessarily a big part of the PnkFrg marketing, right? It's a part, it's quiet on the back end. What do you think about that?
About this. So we are experts in delivering entertainment products. So we are entertainment company in that sense. Gaming is part of a bigger thing. Biggest part of the delivering games or products that are really creating fun, that are creating entertainment for our audience. And it's exactly like you said, we are using Bitcoin and Lightning for a very specific reason to support the creator economy in our experiences. So what we need to build first is really an experience that is super fun, that is super engaging. We need to get all the numbers around like retention, like play sessions, session times, the thickness, everything right before we can even think about integrating the next way that we really have a kind of synergy. Would we only go for integrating Bitcoin? But it would not be a long-lasting product. And that is what to avoid. We are really creating an entertainment product that is on a product, like we know it from the app chart. And for that, we need to get everything right according to this kind of, it's kind of silent. It's supporting a very specific app. It's supporting data economy. It's something completely new in this kind of creator or the industry as well. That is our approach. And it might be interesting for you as well that because the audience is going to the product and is trying the product out and have this feeling like there's not a lot of Bitcoin at the moment what I can feel, what I can try it out. That is exactly what we have done in one of the first tests. We have tested purely the Bitcoin Lightning community. We have tested out in particular some mechanics around the usage of Satoshi, of how we can use it as a reward system. We have done all of have gotten numbers, really outstanding numbers in a way that we should take it out as well, because they are almost too good for getting a good picture, good the whole entertainment angle, what we deliver. So for that reason, we have taken out everything to the Bitcoin related to the Lightning Network. We are focusing purely on the engagement part from an entertainment angle. And I would say the Lightning integration is coming as one of the next steps. Currently, what you see is a wallet which is kind of very small and very soft rewarding element. And one of the next steps after we have closed and all the work is the tipping system, for example, to get even more and stronger rewards also together with Satoshi, these kind of steps. But just for you to get a feeling, it's exactly like you said, focusing on the entertainment part. And as a second step, integrating Lightning as additional tool to support the creator economy.
So I've been playing around with it. I wish I could share this. So when you open it up, it's very TikTok-y. I have the sound down here. But as you can see at the top, I have 27 sats in there. I'm not exactly on the leaderboard just yet. And this is user-generated content. This is something that you would see basically on TikTok or whatever. And the question here is, what's the vibe? What's the vibe of the question? And I have five different answers that I have here. And I'm going to go ahead and choose one that is the question mark, because I actually don't know. And that was well done. I actually got that right. And then it moves on.
I can tell you even something.
Sorry, go ahead.
About this, when you're talking about this one particular game, one of the main ideas of what we have started to play with is exactly like this. What we want to create is something that is more interactive than classic social media, or on the other side, delivering user-generated content to gaming. Because the reason, one strong reason, because both world social media platforms and gaming always look at it that is more interactive. Because as soon as it's more interactive, it's also it's more sticky and it's more immersive. And with this kind of almost very soft interaction we have tried out here in this game, we have a way a time span that is outperforming classic social media that are only kind of watching, for example. And we can also see this in our tests, that not only our test audience is just like, they are playing the games, they're dapping, they're interacting with the videos. And as soon as they're going back to classic format, they're always trying to find the angle to interact. They're always trying to tap on the screen what other formats, other social media platforms are not delivering. And because of this, we can see that the stickiness, the time span is much higher than other platforms. But this is really an outstanding performance.
All right. So let's go through a lightning round of some questions here, because otherwise we're going to get into this and we're going to start posting video, earning sets and all kinds of things. Okay. So the early traction looks good. And that was great. Okay. So given Apple's recent hostility towards Bitcoin Zaps in the Domus app, what are your plans to potentially avoid having any issues there? Or is the App Store monetization model a concern of yours? And is there something that you address to that for this individual who submitted this one here?
Yes. So first of all, I already gave this kind of context. It means for scale, we also need app stores like Google Play Store. And that means we also need to apply to policies on those. But that, having that said, we can't offer APP for in-app purchases based on Satoshi, because that's simply not allowed. We can offer tipping based, the tipping needs to be based angle at specific locations, dishing the game as experience as well. So apply to certain policies of the app source to be aligned they want to have. That is what we're doing. So I'm not right around this at all, because everything what we're doing currently is aligned with the app store policies. I don't see this as a risk at the moment, but working together with app stores for almost 10, 12 years, I can also tell you that those kind of policies, what I see currently is something between two parties, like the app store, the Bitcoin Lightning community, or crypto community on the other side. Those kind of app store policies will change over time, and it's a negotiation currently. From our side, what we have decided, we are policies because we are aiming for a big scale. And for that reason, we're implementing Lightning also in a very specific way that is aligned with the app store policies.
Okay, so touch on the actual monetization. You're giving away Bitcoin. How exactly do you plan on monetizing gameplay within the app? Now, is that something like in-app purchases that are going to come down the line? Is that advertiser? How can you speak about the revenue and monetization of PlayGo, I think?
Yeah, current business model is based on in-advertising. When I'm talking about in-app purchases, so the cash is around 60 from in-app purchases. That is classic. What I'm bringing in this kind of experience in the results, our really deep experience or expertise around classic mobile gaming economies. What you bring in, that means it's coming up from power ups to live energy refill, streak extension, etc. So there are a lot of mechanics what we have created and done in the last 10 years on Candy Crush. So we bring in this one element, and the other element is advertising. On the advertising side, we are more aiming for premium parts. It means we're not aiming for what you usually know from a hyper, like a lot of interstitial in this kind of context for the premium part on the advertising industry. So how model is, part is coming from in-app purchases, another part is coming from advertising, yeah.
So we had a nerdy question here, which people want to know about maybe your tech stack. And what did you use for your implementation? And what SDK did you build on? And who did you partner with is one of our questions here.
So that is quite a simple question for me. I'm not the main tech person, but it goes a little bit in our philosophy, what we touched before, that we are focusing on the engagement. We're focusing on the entertainment. We are experts in creating entertaining products. And that is what we're doing. For that reason, we have chosen to go for a partner who is taking all those kind of challenges from our shoulders. And that's CBD. Of course, it means we are working together, who is delivering doing all the interfaces, we're doing all the solutions around the wallet topic. And that is what we are starting together with CPT integrator, really a good experience so we can focus purely on creating a fun and entertainment product.
Very cool. And Zebedee is the choice of a gaming company for implementation, or so it seems.
Yeah. They have a really good name in the gaming industry. Yeah.
So, okay. So some questions about the, how many full-time, part-time contractors are currently on the team right now? And did you guys work together previously?
So we are currently around full-time employees. A bunch of contractors, around 5 to 7. So on depending on the situation. I like to work usually with this kind of mix of a core team that is around like this size, supported together with contractors, more flexible and scalable up and down depending on need. And if it comes, did we work together? Yes, the founder team, we worked together for several years already at King, partly. So that means we know each other for quite a long time already. We work together for quite a long time. We have the same understanding of development. We have the same understanding of scale, of ambition, what we have. We speak the same language. We know how to give feedback. We read each other pretty well. Everything is quite fast and iterative. And that is what we're doing currently. So yeah, we know each other for a while. We have the same language, a common language, an understanding. And people co-ops 5 to 7 trick.
So mobile game is super competitive. We are also investors. We are not gaming investors. We are Bitcoin-focused investors, but there's a lot of cool stuff going on in the gaming land and the intersection of gaming and Bitcoin. So one of our beloved portfolio companies that we love to death, Thunder Games, Des Dickerson and Jack. Love them. Now, that is a casual mobile gaming studio. And some of the questions are you competing with them? And how do you view kind of other mobile games that have some Bitcoin element in them? And really just a difference between your business and their business. I have a few things that I could say as well. Go ahead. I'll turn it over to you.
I mean, okay, that's a little bit hard, of course, from my side, because from an outside to us, other companies. I would say competing at all in this kind of context. I think Thunder Games is pretty strong, focusing on Bitcoin and Lightning, Lightning games, developing classic format, creating almost like a network around this, creating a lot of infrastructure tech that can be used together with Bitcoin and Lightning. So that's a completely stand we are doing. We are on blockbuster level experiences in a different segment, like section between social media gaming. So the format itself is different. It's user generated based on content, based on mechanics we know from gaming and from social media. It's a very different aspect. It's more like a platform you can use for playing games generated by users, and a very different angle also from a scale, probably, if it comes to the products itself. So in that sense, I would say there's a completely different, completely different positioning around this. But you know, probably know it a little bit better, as you probably have more insights around from your side.
Well, 100%, just like you said, you know, there's the casual mobile gaming studio, as well as the things that they're about to unveil, right? Duels and badges and all sorts of other small mobile casual games. And then there's the blockbuster. Which is what you're out to do.
Yeah.
And that's exactly what it says in our deal memo, but I wanted to get that addressed for this person here. So everyone's all friends, right? Thunder Games, PnkFrg, we're all friends.
Yeah.
How we can line up on some really creative user acquisition campaigns and partnership in the future.
Okay.
So as far as a go-to-market strategy, I have questions about how you're going to do this. And is it going after the creator market first, or do you go through like a gaming channel? And just a real quick, you know, short answer on what do you foresee is the easiest way to really get users when you're full on in get download mode?
So I would say, first of all, there's no easy way. So at work, and we need to really do this in an iterative way like we're doing it with development. Is we are on the one side, we're focusing on content creators, of course, get kind of a creator ambassador to find, get a great place who on that one side more starting content, but on the other side also spread, acting as kind of micro influencers in their this kind of activities. So that is one specific. On the other side, would be a different with this current test. We also start to test different kind of strategies around go to market. We are testing kind of different hyper strategies. That means going in very specific communities, very specific local communities, to get into this kind of community, to get really traction around virality and grow out of this kind of market. That is currently a test run. What we and in parallel on this, we will also user acquisition, as we know it from gaming as well. That is also what we're testing on a really, really nice and low CPM to optimizing also this kind of user acquisition. To summarize it, we're currently working with different scenarios. On the one side, we're optimizing our classic mobile gaming approach with user acquisition. On the other side, we're testing different kind of social media approaches, like, for example, hyper-local communities to support content creation. And the third pillar, what we're doing is we're working with content creators in a content creator ambassador program to support content creation, content liquidity, and micro-influencing. So that is what we're currently doing to prepare step-by-step thing, and then to scale it, we have validation on those topics as well.
Okay, cool. And let's wrap it up by talking about the ramp. And also a little inside joke here for anyone that knows Bobby Shell of Voltage, who's also an investor in our network. Bobby Shell's question was, I have no idea how this works, which means you're just too old. You're too old, yep. Bobby. All right.
Yes.
Okay, cool. So I don't want to put my foot in my mouth. It's all in our deal memo for those people who are in the Lightning Venture Syndicate. Let's just talk about that real quick. Why are we doing these videos? Because we invest in Bitcoin companies, Bitcoin startups, and we are the world's largest angel investing group that's focused only on investing in Bitcoin companies. For low minimums, you can get started, okay? And you can be impactful. You can help these companies. And that's all we do is Bitcoin startups. And we put out these videos. So if you're in the fold, you can read much more in our deal memo. But what we can talk about here as far as who's maybe previously on the cap table, previous investor that you can talk about. But this is a who's who of some big VCs and gaming VCs and a wonderful mix. So in angel investing, we call this signaling, right? Signaling is what other venture capitalists and what other people are participating in around. And it's usually a really good indication for us pikers and small check investors to follow their lead. So I don't want to say anything that I have to edit later because I'm trying to make Tino's job easy. Do you want to talk a little bit about some previous investors or what you can talk about as far as kind of who's aligned with you at this point in time?
So, I mean, we can talk about the previous round. It makes it easier also to cut here. And as you said, it's like the who and who is who in gaming and in Bitcoin as well. Like on the gaming side, we have London Venture Partners, we have Initial Capital and Velo. London Venture Partners and have been our leads in the last round. I would say one of the strongest, most popular early stage investors in gaming. It's also extremely good relation portfolio mix. And on the Bitcoin side, we are proud that we had Oleg from Fulco Ventures on the one side, but also particularly with Liz from Stigler, Oleg and Elif have been incredible help so far. Really amazing to work together with. Yeah, we are extremely proud about our investment. Well, and now I'm looking forward to this round and working together with Lightning Ventures, for example. It's incredible.
Well, you're too kind, that's for sure. Okay, cool. So he said a lot there, and I'll just repeat it one more time. That's Elise Killeen from Stillmark, Folger Venture, who is they're exclusively investing in big companies as well. Okay. Initial Capital, which is focused on gaming. You also share that portfolio company co-investment with Thunder Games, also has invested in them as well. So there's a lot of symmetry. Certainly they don't view you guys as competitor because they are both friendly and investing. And then we got a lot of fancy names. We got Velo. We have London Venture Partners and a couple that can't be named just yet at this point. So this round is almost full and almost closed. Is that right?
Correct. Yes. Almost closed. That's it.
Okay, cool. I think that's going to do it for our interview here today. If anyone wants access to kick the tires and test this out, you can reach out to us and we will be sure to get you a test flight link. And if you're interested in joining Lightning Ventures and investing in companies like Philip, like PnkFrg Studios, and some of the recent deals that we've had, you can certainly join us. Hop in their Discord if you're a gamer or if you want to earn some free sats, win some free sats, taking part in this social Gen Z blockbuster in the making that's going to be really exciting to watch. And hopefully, Philip will be either in Lugano next month or potentially in Amsterdam. So maybe you can catch him in person if you want to hunt him down. Philip, it's been good having you, man. Is there anything that you want to close on or what do you think?
It was a conversation. I'm happy that I had the opportunity and I'm really looking forward to the next steps. I'm thrilled about this and it's a lot of fun. So let's rock and roll amazing.
All right, Philip. Well, hey, man, thanks for coming on and we'll check in with you again real soon.
Bye.